There's some among that aren't too late. Thank you. 20-day runtime. I have been having a pretty rough time of it.
I just want to sit in here and visit with you and talk to you about it and see what I can do.
Is there anywhere you can take taking out?
I have to talk to these guys about doing that. Still trying to find out all that stuff, but.
Me too. I'm trying to find out more about the world that I've been living in too. I never knew that I was in this deep when I was looking at the computer screens when I was in Iraq. I never thought I was.
Sure.
I mean, you can look at, you know.
Yeah.
When you're looking at the screen, it doesn't make sense to you at the time, but then you really realize what's happening, you know.
Yeah.
Like, it's astonishing, you know.
What's this thing having you in this building? And we'll talk about the government. The government wants me to read constitutional rights because you have all those protections and all, so I'm going to read those to you, and then we can talk.
Well, the Constitution cares.
Yeah. Let me just read that, and we'll go from there. You have the right to remain silent and not make any statement at all, and any statement you make may be used against you at your trial. Any statement you make may be used as evidence against you in court. You have the right to have a lawyer present to advise you prior to and during any question. If you are unable to employ a lawyer, you have the right to have a lawyer appointed to advise you prior to and during any question. You have the right to terminate the interview at any time. You understand all your rights. I go around and talk to people a lot. And
I never knew counseling was more, you know, counseling between men and women needed to be more heavy in the world than it did. But when you're surrounded on all fronts where you began, you can't just start in one place, you know.
Right. You understand those rights that they were talking about, right?
What did you find? I've been living with somebody with their hand on my ass my whole life.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
I'm not okay with that. That is not right.
Somebody doing that to you.
It's so sad how it had to happen and stuff, you know, and how it did happen.
Yeah. Yeah, and so
I just wish it'd stop. You know, isn't there a world council that can speak about this?
There has to be
to keep people accountable.
Yeah.
You know.
Right.
Evidently, you know.
You're right.
For stuff like this, that you can't walk on the ground with because they never walked on the same ground with you. You know what I mean?
Right. Well, I want you to know, I work for the Texas Rangers, and what we do is we investigate major crimes, homicides. We have all the resources that we utilize to look into those kinds of cases. You understand what I'm saying?
Right.
And I know what you went through today has been very difficult for you. And I want to talk about what happened. And you can start with when you woke up today and what happened.
Well, you know, I keep talking to Chris, you know. I keep talking to Chris in my world. Seems like every time I talk to another man named Chris, I just get sent to another man named Chris. I think about talking to the wolf, you know, to the one that's got. What? The ones in the sky are the ones that fly, you know what I mean? The pigs in the world, they can truly say they're pigs. I've been smelling it this whole time, you know? I'm just tired of everybody's fucking bullshit. I can smell bullshit and pig shit, you know? I can tell the difference between two different kinds of pigs. Shit, I don't know how you can smell
exactly happened today after you woke up?
I'm finally getting rest. Peace of my mind, you know? Yeah. Peace of my mind back that I won't ever get back.
Where are you from, baby? I mean, I don't know you, understand that. I don't know where you're from.
I was born right here in this land, in Lancaster, that we're standing in today. Lancaster, Texas. This is where I was born. Well, not born, but this is where I was raised.
And what kind of education do you have?
Just high school. I went to high school, I went to the Marine Corps. After I got out of high school, it wasn't the streets that I was turning for, it was the streets I was trying to come back to get. You know, our streets have not been straight here in Texas forever. You know what I mean? No town square. I mean, there's towns that are square and then there's towns that are fixed. And there's no real square town. There can be. There can be square towns around America. There can be crooked towns.
Sure.
You know.
What did you do in the Marine Corps?
I worked as a prison guard. And I worked on the gun, so. It's like tit for tat, you know?
Yeah.
Who's saying who's right and who's wrong? You know, nobody wants to admit that they're right. Mm-hmm. Nobody wants to admit that they're wrong.
Mm-hmm.
I'm the only man that can change it.
Yeah.
And that's why he's there behind my back right now.
Yeah. How long were you in the Marine Corps?
4 years.
How did you meet Chris?
Well, he was the one that was protecting the schools, you know, from my mom. You know, my mom, she was a teacher. So,
school teacher.
Now, I finally met the guy, I could tell him, you know, I smelled it for what it was worth, and I was like,
what's his last name?
He was a Kyle.
Kyle?
Yeah, he was Kyle.
Right. And what's that other guy's name?
I couldn't even remember.
And when was the first time you met the other guy?
First time I ever met one of them was yesterday. I didn't know who they were, you know.
Yeah. Okay.
I knew who they were, but I didn't know, you know, who they were.
Okay.
Very evident now who they were, because I'm obviously here on the top side of the world, so.
Yeah.
No, no.
Well, how did you meet them? Did you meet them at your house, or did...
They came and got me at my house, so.
And then where did they take you?
We drove down into the country out there, and then they went and did some shooting sports, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
What kind of shooting sports?
Well, I imagine they're headhunters, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to hunt everybody down. They did them wrong before, you know. I'm not trying to hunt down anybody that I did wrong. Are you?
I try to be as reasonable and normal as I can.
I try to be as normal and as reasonable as I can every day, and I think about it every day, and I'm like, I'm pretty damn reasonable.
Yeah.
I'm pretty damn fair.
Right. What happened out there today on
those
shooting sports? What kind of guys?
I was reasonable and fair with the boys, you know. They looked at me in the eyes, and I looked at them in the eyes, and then...
And now what happened to them today is from your perspective?
Well, I can't just keep eating my soul up about this, you know.
soul up for free, you know? It's not what it's about. It's about having the soul that you have in you for yourself. And I still got tons of people that are eating on my soul right now. I haven't even been able to sleep. Because I've been waiting for them to come back and get my soul.
Yeah.
You know that feels.
I understand.
You know?
Yeah.
I just wish the world wasn't such a soulless place, you know? Sometimes it feels like there's no soul for the soup anymore, anywhere. I feel like I'm going to be writing down books and
well, tell me what's happening out there. Have you heard Chris and that other guy?
Well, you know, I've seen, evidently Tommy Dixon's party wants to run rampant in America. Tommy Dixon times are here upon us, you know? Reds are already eating up all the Indians. We know that. It's tragedy. The ones that can't eat the Indians, it won't, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to have problems about them. I can't see the heat. There's got to be a common ground for me to work on at it better so we can all get better, you know. There's got to be common grounds. The warlords aren't very happy with me. I know that. Everybody knows that in town. I can start making things right. I mean, obviously.
You saw your sister today. And you told her something bad happened, right? What did you tell her?
I told her I had to kill men today. It wasn't a want to or a need. It was a need. I had to get out of that situation I was in today. That may have not known. I was going to be the next one that was going to be up there getting my head shot completely off, you know.
And how many did you have to kill today?
Two. I'd much rather put in work, you know, against it, but
when did you kill my weapon?
It was a pistol.
What caliber?
It was a 9.
It was a 9? Was this a semi-automatic or revolver?
It was just a semi-automatic.
What brand gun?
I think it was a SIG. It was a SIG Sauer, you know.
Mm-hmm. What did you do with that gun?
Well, selling that truck, that's why I took it, you know. When I pulled back into town, because people feel like I could talk to Jesse or anybody like that. Nobody wanted to talk to me about what was right to do. Everybody wants me to do the right thing.
Sure.
But nobody wants me to pay for it.
Right.
I know it's right. Everybody wants me to live for free out on these farms that are high fence and stuff and just shoot for a living. Well, I mean, I can keep shooting for a living.
How many times did you shoot down today?
A couple few. A couple few shots were fired.
How close were you to them?
Hell, I was right up close to him. I didn't mean to be so close, but...
Did they know you were going to shoot?
They didn't know.
Why do you think that?
Because their training wasn't as good. My training's been better, you know, my life.
Who did you shoot first?
Uh, with a better, you know, clearly identify. The only way I could clearly identify that was, I knew if I did not take out his soul, he was coming to take mine next. Or something like his gangsters was coming to take one of my souls next, one of his kids' gangsters. I'm just tired of playing chess with my life. It's not, yeah, it's not about playing chess pieces in life. I mean, it is about playing chess pieces in life, obviously.
Yeah.
The chess holds the power.
Right. Was there a time today you used any drugs?
Yeah, I did use some tobacco today.
And some other kind of drugs?
That's true, right? Pure adrenaline, yes.
Yeah.
I've been running on pure adrenaline for a couple of days now straight. This is one of the first time I've got to feel safe with up here at this police station.
Right.
With more police around me.
Yeah, I was kind of looking at your eyes a little bit constricted. I thought maybe you might have used some methamphetamine or something today.
I have not.
Oh, you have not?
I did not.
Have you used
it? I've been having such a hard time sleeping because I haven't been taking drugs, and I can't sleep at night. Well, who can sleep in that world? Sandman keeps winning, you know what I mean? I tell what I know is right to get out the front door. Well, they just keep coming back in my ass to buy me some more. Yeah, don't, you know.
Yeah. Let me ask you, Eddie, have you ever used methamphetamine before? Never.
Drugs are what's bringing us into these wars, anyways. I know it is. It's about what drugs can get done the fastest by the quickest. Drug lords will. It's not about that, it's about getting everybody healthy together, you know. you can eat souls when you're down here, you know, the ones that you're given. But you can never make any more after the ones, the true souls are gone, you know. Once all the true souls are gone, you're fucked.
About what time did this happen today after you got
range? I don't know, maybe around 2 o'clock or so.
And after you killed him, what did you do next?
I fled. I didn't know what else to do. My adrenaline was so high, I didn't know what was right, I didn't know what was wrong. I mean, I know what was right now, but I left, you know.
The keys to the vehicle you drove away in. know what you do today is wrong, right? You understand that?
Yes, sir.
That's the reason you flat her out, because you knew it was wrong?
Well, I knew that there was certain shit that was wrong about it.
Some of that certain shit was killing him. You knew that was wrong. Right?
Right.
And you knew driving away, thinking that truck was wrong. And where did you drive to after that?
Well, if I was alright, should have just stayed.
Are you asking me, should you have stayed? Yes. Shouldn't have done it in the first place. You know, his men, they're heroes.
Right.
You understand that? Ultimate heroes.
Right.
They've been protecting you and me
for a while now.
For a long, long.
Long longer than I was thinking.
Yeah.
I guess I need to be doing more thinking in this town than than hurting people.
Right. Was there a bomb, like a drug bomb, in some of your stuff?
Tobacco.
Is that what was in the bomb? Is that true or not? I don't know. You know, you have to be truthful with me. If it wasn't, just be true. What was in that bomb?
I imagine some. There's probably some pot in there, too. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit of pot.
All right. And what else?
You know, shit you can't trust anything in Texas with weed in it, because usually laced up so fucking tight with different drugs.
Mm-hmm. If yours was laced, what do you think it would have been laced with?
Probably some of that wet, or I don't know, could have been anything.
What do you mean by that? Could have been wet? What?
Could have been any kind of particular drug that was put in the weed, you know.
Where did you get it?
I haven't bought any in a while.
Had you used it today? You have?
Yeah.
And you're being truthful with me?
Yes, sir. I smoked a little bit today.
Okay.
I've been trying to relax, and I've been relaxing me. The only thing that was happening to me was pot. You know, that it was growing here and helping me. Now that I've got so many abandonment issues and trust issues here, I don't know what the fuck to think, you know. I've been having these problems in my town since I was growing up, you know, since a boy. I'm trying to fix this shit that's wrong or our country right now.
did these guys say to you today when you were with them? What did they tell you?
They didn't really talk to me about much, you know, they were just, you know, talking about a common man, you know.
Yeah, tell me what they said to you.
Well, you can't walk around and become a man in a world of slaves, you know.
Mm-hmm. Is that what they told you?
If that's what the world is saying, yeah.
I want you to tell me about
a mistake. I'm not a mistake. I'm tired of missing out on my life because of this shit.
I want you to tell me what these men told you today, these heroes that you were with. Tell me what they told you today.
Well, you know, they're telling me about, you know, like stuff they've done, stuff they've experienced and stuff. Well, I've already seen that stuff in another pond.
You have?
Yeah. When I came back to this one, and it's happening more and more rapid, even more here in Lancaster than anywhere, you know.
And how are they helping you today?
Who's that?
Which men? The men that you killed, how are they helping you today? When they were talking to you?
Talked to me pretty shitty, but, you know. Pretty shitty.
What did they say? Did you do any target practicing today?
I did.
Tell me about that.
Well, you know, I loaded up a 45 and I shot at it. You know.
What kind of distance?
Wasn't a distance or anything, but it was out there a little ways, you know. Wasn't far. But still hit my mark when I was even hit my mark true, you know.
Absolutely. What else did you shoot today? What kind of 45 was it you shot? Did some target practicing with?
It was I guess it was like a revolver.
Was that gun used to shoot anyone today? Thank you. guns did you target practice with today?
Well, there's a bunch of other ones out there, fully autos out there, and I never shot any of the targets though.
Those boxes of other guns you mentioned, did you shoot anything with them?
No. I left them for what they were. So we're meant to be here for its hunting purpose.
Was the other guy named Chad?
So is there anywhere I can see my parents yet? Did they make it in yet?
I have not heard.
Anybody heard about them yet?
I haven't heard that.
You can talk out there and see if they've heard from them.
Sure.
I'd like to see them, see if I can at least hug my mom one last time.
He shot Chad and Chris, right?
Yep.
He's your dad, right there. What's your date of birth, Eddie?
9/30/87. I gotta get these cuffs off the back of my neck. Before I start eating, before I keep strangling my fucking one out, so. The wall ain't that thick in here. Or heavy. I'll be back. So I was wondering about my mom and dad, are they in town yet, or?
I would check with his.
Okay.
I guess I have to admit, when he's coming back, I'm going to check with his, and see if he's, I could say,
Did they ever get any presents taken off?
Yeah.
Just like the animal conflict?
At this right there, this time, not like that.
I wish I could.
to them and then we come.
Right.
And why are you talking to them? Let you go down there?
I don't know.
Thank you.
with you. The 9mm, the SIG that you said you used to kill him with, is that your personal SIG?
No, that was the other guy's.
Okay.
So.
Alright. What did they do after you shot them? Can you explain that to me?
They lay there, and they weren't breathing anymore, so.
Okay. About what time did that happen? The clothes that you have on now, where did you get those?
From my mom.
What were you wearing today out there when you, at the gun range? That's what you were wearing? You didn't change clothes? I'm gonna step out of here and get these guys to get back with you. I told you where your family was at.
Quality counts.
Yeah, that's where your family's at. And the other one of the family's out there grieving, right? And you know the difference between between right and wrong, right?
Yes, sir.
You do? All right, let me see if I can go see what these other guys are doing, okay?
Sure, I'm gonna talk to me about maybe.
You talk to me about it when they come up here, okay?
Okay.
You have a cell phone or anything like that for yourself? You have it on you? Try to run from the police, right? Isn't that right? I heard him talking to you, trying to get you to give up. What I heard him saying is, just come get out. Surrender, right? Why weren't you compliant? Because of what happened. Okay.
Yep.
What do you want to tell your mom?
I love her.
What do you tell your sister?
I love her too.
She wishes that it never happened. Like you won't cry about it.
There's a little.
I see the water in your eyes.
Yeah.
If you take it back, you would. Any blood on your boots?
Okay.
Thank you.